Okay guys, in this video we are going to discuss about how we can scaffold. Scaffolding is a process where you can generate the code from an existing predefined functionalities. So normally in the previous session we had seen how to create action methods and how to post the data and how to use this get method and how to create views and all those. So this particular project is very important, whatever I am going to discuss in this video. So by using any of the model from entity framework, either it is code first or DB first or anything, so how we can generate the code completely with all read write actions, that is what our functionality. So here I am going to create one more fresh application. So MVC, as this, as I said, don't use this configure. Sorry if I'm in earlier videos if I said to use it. So delete this one. So after that, authentication always should be no authentication, guys. About this authentication, we can discuss it the later at the time of API and all those. So click on create. So now the project is getting created. So once the project creation is successful, create the controllers as it is, because we want to go from the scratch. So even here also in views we are going to delete the same. First of all, let's forget about it is an MVC application. So here I just want to use code first approach because models will be helpful for us. So in the models you can go right click and click on a new class. So example, let me take a product class. So this is code first approach, guys. I hope you remember. So before going with properties, let me install this NuGet package. Further also it is required for us. So manage NuGet packages for solution. So in the browse, so let's install entity framework. So select the project and install that one. So click on OK, accept the license. So guys, this task is more important for us because in assessments also we'll get the same kind of thing. So here, let's take an example, public int id as it is. So product string title string category. Double price, something like this. So I'm just taking one particular table. I just want to make it as a class. So just let me add annotation. This I just want to make it as a key. So for title, we are just going to make it as a required. Category also required. Price is also required. So let me use not required, let's use the same. So this is my model class. So now here let's create a context class. So context class is an optional, either you can go in the models folder or else you can create it outside also, anything is fine. For adding more references, just get it at in the outside itself. So here I'm taking a class. So here some sales context. So I'm going to inherit DB context. I hope you remember all these steps. So we are inheriting the predefined class. Next I'm going to create a constructor. So I'm going to pass to the base class the connection string. So here in the web.config, let's create the connection string. So here I am going to create the connection string. So in the connection strings, let me add a name is equal to some DB connection. So connection string and provider name. Guys, don't miss this provider name, especially for code first approach. So system dot data dot SQL client. So connection string I am going to pass. So first data source is equal to server name. So my server name is this one. So initial catalog is equal to db010 something, some database name. So I'm using Windows authentication integrated security equal to true. So this is what my connection string. Now just copy this connection string name and provide it to the base class context. And after that, you know that you we have to prepare the db sets, public db set of what is the class name that we created, that is products. So product, not products. So product, let's give the name products. Now let's give the getters and setters for this. So that's it. So this is not accessible because so this particular data sales context is outside of the folder. So normally products is there inside the models folder. That is the reason either you have to import from this or else if you take mouse on this it will ask you to import that particular folder here. So that is using the project name dot models folder, then it is going to be accessible. That's it. This is the regular step, no doubt at all till this one. Go to this package manager console. So here first enable migrations, enable hyphen migrations. Did I see anything wrong? Enable spelling wrong. Enable migrations. So in migrations are enabled, add hyphen migration initial so the migration was added. Update the database. So the database was updated. Now here databases, so db001 tables, and we have these products and you can see the columns also, id, title, category and price. So this is same whatever we used earlier, the same it is going to be. Now let's see this. Here right click on the controllers, go to add and select a controller, and here instead of taking an empty one, let's select the last one, MVC5 controller with views. So you are going to create a controller along with the views with the help of entity framework. So click on add. So guys, sorry for this. Before doing this step, let's build the project. So you can rebuild the project. Then you can right click on the controllers, go to add and select a controller. Select this MVC5 controller with views and using entity framework. Here you need to select what is the model class. Model class, so product is my model, I am selected that one. So here you are going to get db context. So database context is so sales context, you select that one. So here generate views to be selected, scripts to be selected, otherwise validations are not going to be performed. So this is the one which you will get the default design from the layout.cshtml page. So here the suggested controller name is products controller, even I am also suggesting the same. So click on add. If you are not building the project at this step, it is going to throw an error. That is the reason build the project and create the controller later. So it is what called scaffolding. Scaffolding is nothing but so generating the code from an existing model by using the entity framework, generating the code. So it is like a compressed to uncompressed code. So now you will get a controller along with views, you can see this. So products controller is there. So we have create, delete, details, edit and index. Index is by default it is going to get displayed. So let's build once again. So after once build is successful, Now you can execute your application and check how it is going to be useful for us. So here, let me select the data here. So as of now, no records are there. It is going to be empty. That we all know that. So select the top 1000 records. Getting hand. Yes, so as of now there are no records. Now this application, so our controller name to execute is products. So now index view is index action method is getting executed. Now you can see the number of records of this particular products table from this SQL server. As of now, no records, so that you can see an empty one. There are no records. Okay. So here you will get an option create new. So I'm giving the title. Suppose an example, iPhone 12 Pro. So category mobiles. So price is some 98,000. So click on create. Now this is that record was included in the database. If you have any query about that, so come to this database and you can check the record was inserted. ID is 1. So now in case if I want to edit, I can click on this edit option. So suppose I just want to change the price from 76,000. If you click this, so immediately that also will get affected here. You can see this one. In case if you want to see the record detail, if it is a very large one, if you click this, you can see in detail. So if you want to delete, if you click this, you will get a confirmation, and if you click on delete, this is going to get deleted. You can see it here also. So this is how every read write action can be performed by using the entity framework. This is what called scaffolding. Scaffolding. Okay. So just observe what happened. So by scaffolding this particular. So every time we are going to write using sales context, DB is equal to new sales context, it was created as a global object. Okay, so whenever we are calling index, it is going to send data to the view. Send data to the view. This is also the next topic, whatever I am going to discuss, how to send data. So from view to this index view, we are passing whatever the sales context object dot products dot to list. So the products table is being converted into list format, that is being sent to this index. So let's go with index and observe what happened here. So here it has taken the model. Model is nothing but the input, whatever it is receiving in a enumerable format, or else you can also take list of web model, web application 2 dot models dot product. The input, whatever we are sending it here. So this is going to be the model for this particular view. Okay. So then based on that view, they are going to repeat by a for each loop. They are displaying title, category and price. That's it. So if it is confusing you, you can use our regular for each loop. I will cover this this specific record in the next video. Okay. So this is how index will work. Coming to the details. So as I said, if you remember my previous session where I said URL pattern is also going to take an input in this question mark, I mean query string format. So here they're asking whichever the record you are clicking, that particular record ID is going to be taken. So this is for product details, in case if you want to see detailed. So if there is ID, no ID, ID equal to null, so then we are going to return it is a bad request. That means it is not an expected format, it is going to return the bad request code 400. So then browser will display it is a wrong URL. Okay. So otherwise if it is there by using the find method products.find of ID, so then whatever the record that we found, that is going to be saved in this object. If that is also null, so it is going to post it is not found. That means whatever the ID that you are requesting, that is not there. Okay. If it is found, that is going to be displayed to the view again product. So there earlier we had sent list of products. Now this time we are sending only one product. If you go to this details view, again the model, earlier it is list of web models 2 dot models dot product. Here it is only single one. That is the reason you no need any for each loop. Directly you can print dot title dot category dot price or whatever the thing that you want. If it is confusing you, you can also write directly So at the rate model dot whatever the attribute, like this also you can print, both are same. So display for model column model dot price and directly M capital letter model dot price, both are same. So any format you can print, that is the precise format, that is the reason they are using like that one. So this is how you can get the detail. So create is nothing but, so create we can do it however we already discussed by using the code first or DB first approach. So you are going to take DB products dot add of product, after that DB save changes, that's it. Okay, so once it is added, they are redirecting it to index view. Index view. So normally we will write return view. So whenever you want to redirect to another view, we are going to use a return redirect to action of index view. So edit also same. You will get an ID. If ID is null, you are throwing it as bad request. If you found by using the find method, so if you didn't found, it is going to throw this HTTP not found. That's it. So whenever you want to edit, so it is going to take the status, bind the status of the existing ID, title, category and product. So it is going to change the state, that means whatever the new values you will add into this current input, so these are going to be saved. This is what called update or edit method. So delete is also same, first it will check for ID. If ID is not found, it is going to throw it as bad request. So if you found, if it is also null again, so it will throw ID is incorrect. So then if it is found, it is going to use this return view of product. So again we are going to display. So to delete again, we are going to use dot remove method. Maybe this code looks bit lengthy. So if it is confusing you, we can use whatever the previous code you learned from my previous sessions of code first or DB first approach in entity framework. So this is what called scaffolding. So where you can easily utilize a model, instead of creating a model, let us use that same database models whatever we created. From that you can create a controller and along with the views also. This is the advantage of MVC mostly. So where it is going to be developer friendly, instead of writing multiple lines of code, it will save the time and effort for us. So I hope this scaffolding is clear to everyone. So in the next session we can continue the remaining.